The purpose of a power grid or a power distribution system is to transfer power from the place where it's produced to the place where it's used. In this video, I'd like to take a closer look at the differences between AC transmission and DC transmission. AC stands for alternating current and DC stands for direct current. And in the late 1800s, there was a contest between the two. Ultimately, power distribution using alternating current won out. I'd like to show you a picture of the World's Fair in 1893, which took place in Chicago. At the start of the fair, on May the 1st, President Grover Cleveland of the United States threw a switch and lit up 100,000 lights. It must have been spectacular. That particular fair signaled the end of direct current. There were two major companies who had put in bids to electrify the World's Fair that year. One company was called General Electric. Until the previous year, it was known as the Edison Lighting Company. The other company who'd put in a bid, and the company that won, was the Westinghouse Electric and Manufacturing Company. The painting of Thomas Edison here shows him sitting on a desk working on his phonograph machine. Phonographs in those days weren't the flat discs that we see today, but were rather cylinders. Thomas Edison was known not only for the phonograph, of course, but for the electric light and a number of other inventions. Although Thomas Edison favored DC, he didn't win the so-called Battle of the Currents, which played out, the culmination of which was the 1893 World's Fair. Let's take a look at why AC transmission might be superior to DC transmission. Let's simplify our DC power station as a Thevenin equivalent voltage source and a Thevenin equivalent resistance, which I'm here calling just R internal. We know that we're going to have to deliver power to a load. Let's call the resistance of that load R sub load, and then let's call the resistance of the lines R sub line. I'm going to roll three of these resistors into one. For example, we know that the line resistance can all be rolled into a single line, and then furthermore, we can combine the line and the internal resistance at the power plant into a single line since they're all in series with one another. So now I only have two resistors left, the line resistance and the load resistance. And I want to ask the following question. Assuming that I want to deliver a fixed amount of power to the load, is it better to operate my power station at a high voltage, or is it better to operate my power station at a low voltage? Let's work an example to illustrate which way might be better. Let's assume in the low voltage case that I'm going to operate my power plant at 230 volts. In the high voltage case, let's assume that I'm going to operate my power plant at 23 kilovolts. Next, in each case, let's assume that the power delivered to the load is 1 kilowatt. Let's assume that my net line resistance is 13 ohms in both cases. Because the current is different in the two cases, I know that the load resistor is going to have to be different. Rather than calculate the value of the load resistance, I'm just going to say what the correct answer is. It won't be very difficult to verify that it's correct. In the low voltage case, the required load resistance is 10 ohms, and in the high voltage case, the required load resistance is nearly 529 kiloohms. Let's first verify that the power in these two cases is indeed the same. We can first calculate the current. In the low voltage case, the current is 10 amperes. In the high voltage case, the current is only 43.48 milliamps. It's rather easy to verify that the load power, 1 kilowatts, is equal to I squared times the load resistance in both of these cases. Now, given that we've delivered 1 kilowatts to the load in both situations, I now want to ask the following question. In which case is more power burned up along the line? The low voltage case or the high voltage case? Well, we can very easily calculate the power burned up on the line. We can use the same formula, P equals I squared R. For the low voltage case, the power lost along the line is 1300 watts. However, in the high voltage case, because the current flowing through the line is a lot less, the power lost along the line is only 24 milliwatts. This is a huge difference in power lost along the line, and this is a clear demonstration why, as far as power distribution goes, it's a lot better to use higher voltages. With higher voltages, you have less current flowing through the lines, and consequently, less power is burned up in the power distribution system itself. However, as far as the end user goes, we don't want to use voltages that are too high because they tend to be dangerous. Therefore, to have a good power grid, we need to have the following two features. We need high voltages when we're transmitting the power over great distances, but we need low voltages when we're actually using the power. The key benefit of an AC power transmission system over a DC transmission system is this ability to change the voltages easily. And when I say easily, I mean we can use a transformer. Of course, with DC, there are ways to change the voltages from low to high and back again, but these tend to involve complicated circuitry. With AC, one needs only to use a transformer with proper turns ratio. In an AC power grid, the power generators can operate at their most efficient voltages, the power distribution can operate at a very high voltage for efficiency's sake, and then the end user only has to deal with relatively low voltages that tend to be safe. Let N refer to the number of turns of wire around that transformer. So N1 in this first example represents the number of turns around the primary, and N2 represents the number of turns around the secondary. Since a turbine would typically operate at a lower voltage than the transmission line, we would have fewer turns on the primary than the secondary. The ratio of turns corresponds exactly to the voltage ratio of the transformer. Near the load, we expect the voltage to be a lot lower than that of the power distribution system. Therefore, we expect to have a larger number of turns on the primary than the secondary. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.